because there are sides that are suffering.
Veterans are upset, and Andrew Scheer is more than willing to listen to them explain how they feel the Trudeau government has mistreated them over the last 4 years. Sunday, the Conservative leader promised, if elected, he would clear the backlog of veterans' benefits applications within 2 years, strike an independent inquiry to get answers about why members of the armed forces were administered mefloquine, and to enshrine in legislation a military covenant between the government and all veterans to ensure that they are treated with respect and provided services in a timely manner. But it's not clear exactly how it would be enforced.
What we're doing with this is changing the culture within the government.
A culture that some around this table believe doesn't respect veterans. Tyler Cody served in Afghanistan and sat beside Scheer, but he doesn't think the Tories are on his side.
Conservatives were terrible for veterans. There's no plans that he's actually talked about. He didn't say how he would do it. So I'm not too optimistic about any party.
When asked about his party's past treatment of veterans, Scheer deflected.
How do veterans trust the conservatives when it was the conservatives in 2014 that shut so many of the Veterans Affairs offices?
Well, what veterans saw was in the 2015 election that they were used as props. And that the promises that were made to them were not delivered. So this is my solemn engagement with them.
Lip service after lip service. Now we have a conservative leader coming forward. I could close my eyes and that could have been Mr. Harper. We're Mr. Trudeau. But at the end of the day, we're still waiting. Veterans are still suffering.
The Liberals contend they've invested heavily in veterans to the tune of $10 billion. And they point out it was the Trudeau government that reopened those 9 Veterans Affairs offices, which were closed by the previous Conservative government. Robin,
Mike Le Couteur in St. John's, Newfoundland.